Hello friends, welcome to Design Patterns video series. I am Pranaya Kumar Rout, having 10 years of working experience. In this Design Pattern video series, I am going to discuss all the design patterns with real-time examples using different types of applications such as web application, web API and console applications. It is very easy to understand and implement design patterns in real-time applications. Writing the code with the design patterns will make your application more reliable, scalable, and maintainable. Then the next question is, this video series is for whom? If you are a student or a beginner or a professional software developer, then you are at the right place. This design pattern video series is designed for students, beginners, as well as professional developers who wants to learn design patterns with real-time examples step by step from the very basic concepts to the advanced concepts of design patterns. This design pattern video series provides a hands-on approach to the subject with step-by-step programming examples that will assist you to learn and put the knowledge into practice. What language is used in this course? As I am a .NET developer, so I am going to use C# as the programming language. But it is up to you, even though if you want, then you can also do the same using Java, Python, etc. But that is your responsibility for how to implement the code in this language. Here I will explain the concept in a manner that will be easy to understand, and you can use any programming language as per your experience. Then the next question is history and evolution of design patterns. The four authors of the book Elements of Reusable Object-Oriented Software, famously known as Gang of Four, is the ones who brought the concept of design patterns. They have divided the book into two parts, with the first part explaining the pros and cons of object-oriented programming, and the second part describes the evolution of 23 classic software design patterns. Then the most important question is, what are design patterns? Design patterns are nothing but, you can say, documented or tested solutions for recurring problem in a given context. Or in other words, we can also say that design patterns are reusable solutions to the problems that as a developer we encountered in our day-to-day programming. Design patterns are basically used to solve the problems of object generation and integration. The second point is, the design pattern is not a silver bullet. Let us understand what it means. While developing your project, you know your project requirement better. We have many design patterns. Take the design pattern as a reference and see, does the design pattern really solve your project problem? If yes, then only use the design pattern. The third point is, do not overdo design patterns. Let us understand what it means. One thing you need to remember is, design patterns are for projects and projects are not for design patterns. I saw many developers are enforcing the design patterns into their project, which makes the project messy. So use the design patterns only when required. If not required, then don't use. Then the next question is, types of design patterns. Gang of Four, which is commonly known as GOF, categorized the design patterns into three main categories based on three problem areas of software architecture. The first problem area is object creation and initialization. The second problem area is structural changes of classes, interfaces, and the relationship between them. And the third problem area is communication between the objects. Based on these three problem area, Gang of Four divided the 23 design patterns into three categories. The first category is creational design pattern, which is basically to deal with object creation and initialization. The second category is structural design pattern, which is basically to deal with structural changes of classes and interfaces and the relationship between them. The last category is behavioral design pattern, which is basically to deal with the communication between object. Let us understand the basic concept of all these three design patterns. The first is creational design pattern. The creational design pattern deals with the object creation and initialization. This design pattern gives the programmer more flexibility in deciding which objects need to be created and initialized for a given case. For example, if we have a huge project means we have a lot of classes. A lot of classes means we are dealing with a lot of objects. So we need to create different types of object like customer object, product object, employee object, payment object, invoice object, etc. based on some conditions. If the object creation logic based on some condition is implemented inside the client code, then it leads to a lots of complicated logic in the client code. That means if the object creation and initialization logic are not centralized, then it leads to be a very complicated code. The creational design pattern help us to centralize the object creation and initialization logic, and based on the condition, it will create and initialize the appropriate object and returns that object to the client. The examples of creational design patterns are singleton, builder, prototype, fluent interface, factory, factory method, and abstract factory design patterns. The next is structural design pattern. Right. The structural design pattern is basically used to manage the structural changes of classes and interfaces, as well as used to manage the relationship between them. For example, if we have a customer and product class, and the product class is used inside the customer class, making one-to-many relationship. That is, one customer can buy many products. Tomorrow, as the project changes, tomorrow as the project proceeds, the requirement changes. Now we want to keep away the product class from the customer class, as we want to use the product and customer classes independently. This is a structural change, and we don't want this structural change to affect our project. This is where structural design pattern comes into picture. The examples of structural design patterns are adapter, facade, decorator, composite, proxy, flyweight, and bridge design pattern. The third one is behavioral design pattern. The behavioral design pattern deals with the communication between classes and object. That means if you want to change the behavior of a class, and again you want it to affect other classes of the project as well. For example, if you have an invoice class that currently applying the tax as 18%. Tomorrow, if you have to add another extra tax, that means you are changing the behavior of a class. To solve such types of problems, behavioral design patterns comes into the picture. The examples of behavioral design patterns are change of responsibility, command, observer, iterator, state, template, visitor, strategy, mediator, memento, and interpreter design pattern. Then prerequisite. So basically, how easily you are going to understand the design pattern, that depends on how strong you are in object-oriented programming concepts. So to take the full advantage of this design pattern course, it is very important for you to have at least the basic knowledge of the following OOPS concept: class and object, abstraction, inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation, interfaces, abstract classes. If you want to learn these OOPS concepts in detail, the link for the same is provided in the video description section, where you can learn these concepts with real-time examples. What next? In the next video, I'm going to discuss the singleton design pattern with examples. The singleton design pattern belongs to creational design pattern category. In this video, I just give you a brief introduction to design patterns, and I hope you enjoy this video. I'm going to use C# as the programming language while coding. But if you want, then you can also use other programming languages as per your experience, like Java, Python, etc. The concept is going to be the same. Once you understand the concept, then language doesn't matter. In case you need the code and text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. Thank you for watching this video.